All right, so we went through all of these improvements. Brace yourself, it's time for some of the new features. And here is where it's going to be very interesting. In the model element panel, take a look at this beautiful thing over here. This is the new curb ramp tool. So as you open the curb ramp feature, you get this window over here and this diagram that shows you the different parts of the curb ramp, the ramp running, the side flare, and the target element. So under the diagram, we have these three checkpoints over here. These are actually three different types of curb ramps that you can create, and I'm going to show you each and every one of them. So let's start with 2 points with flare. Under that, you have the settings. So what is the ramp running slope? For me, it's 8% because that's the standard here in Israel. But you can use whatever value you want over here to make sure you're ADA compliant or compliant with any standards that you want. And then I'm going to define the flare lateral slope, which means the slope that will go on the curbstone of the sidewalk. So that's the slope over here. I'm going to leave the slope to target element check, and that's what I'm going to show you now. So what does it mean, target element? For example, I want a ramp that goes from the sidewalk to the target that is the road, all right? And next, we have the option to change the material. Now, why do we need to change the material? Basically, this is a very simple feature that takes the floor or the toposolid and just modifies its sub-element. But a lot of times we want to be able to see, to visualize this ramp. But also, if we change the material, it means that we can use a material takeoff and really schedule the area of this material. So I'm going to click over here, and then I'm going to get the material libraries in Revit. Let's click on curb ramp, select this yellow material, click on OK, and you can see it changed over here. And last, we have the place ramp family. It's checked, which means we will have a certain family that we can later schedule, and we will see it in a second. So now let's go to the magic. So I'm going to click anywhere on the sidewalk. Environment is going to realize on its own where are the edges of the sidewalk. I'm going to click here again, and I'm going to click on the road now. So the road is my target. And now environment has changed the sub elements. Yes, I want to update the slab contours. Thank you very much. So the contours on my sidewalk will change accordingly. And yeah, basically that's it. So 3 clicks and I have a ramp. Let's try the 2 points without flare. And this time I'm going to start from the road all the way to the sidewalk. So click 1, 2, 3, and we have a ramp. Let's do it again. 4 points by sketch, no flare. This time I'm going to uncheck the slope to target element, and I'm going to manually define the vertical distance between the sidewalk and the road. I'm going to click 1, 2, 3, 4, and then it will just change. You can see the kind of ramp that we have. By the way, you also have undo and redo options embedded within the feature, so I can just undo this ugly ramp and go back over here and show you how it reacts when we have a curved road. So 1, 2, you can see it getting curved, 3, all the way to the road. And then we have the curved ramp. All right, thank you for being a reliable feature. Whenever you demonstrate a software, that's really a scary thing. I have to tell you, it's not for the weak-hearted. All right, so let's click on OK, and I want to share with you one last tip about this tool. So, you know, 2 last tips. Remember I told you there's a family for you to schedule. So basically what we're doing is creating this line-based adaptive family. And the only purpose for this to be here is for you to have something to schedule, pedestrian curb ramp, so you can know how many you have in your project. But another thing that I wanted to tell you is that if you remember from before, these are just changes to the sub-elements, right? It's the same surface. But let's say that I really hate this yellow that I chose before. What would I do now? I can simply go to the Modify tab and use the regular Revit Remove Paint or Paint option. So I can just go to Remove Paint and get rid of it. So nothing that you do is unchangeable, right? Everything is for you to be able to change back. Let's do curb ramp 1, 2, 3, okay? So we're always riding on Revit native tools, really to allow you to live within the Revit ecosystem, to have a healthy file.